Hi, I'm Doug. I'm a writer at Microsoft. Many folks working from home want to connect their laptop to a secondary monitor. Many folks have extra ones, or they grab theirs from work, or they've bought one. So I'm going to show you how to connect it to your laptop and also the software inside Windows 10 to make it work best for you. Now, the first thing we have to talk about, unfortunately, is cables. Sorry, it just has to happen. One, hopefully you have a power cord, that's one, but the second is how to connect it. Now there's two different types. This is an HDMI, and this is the DisplayPort. They're pretty similar. An HDMI is a very universal cord that's been around for years for electronics. You probably have these hanging around the house. They've been used in computer games and connecting things like DVD players and things like that to your TV set. A hybrid of that is a DisplayPort. It's built especially for computer monitors, so it's a little more powerful, it's a little different, but it's harder to find around if you have them hanging around the house. There's a little difference here. Let me show you the connections here. The DisplayPort's on top, it's a little bigger, it has that telltale notch. Also, it's got this button you have to press when you click it in and out of things. It's usually found with desktop computers, so if you want to plug it directly into your laptop, you're going to need some sort of adapter. So I'm going to show you HDMI, one, because again, a lot of people probably have these hanging around the house if they're trying to figure out how to get it connected, and many laptops have a connection for HDMI, so you can plug this directly into your monitor. And if you don't, like my Surface Book, there's an adapter you can probably have that would connect it to it. So let me show you connecting up a computer monitor. So I've taken the HDMI cord, I've connected it to the back of the monitor in the HDMI slot, and then here I'll plug it into my laptop. A lot of monitors have controls up here, power button and a source button. The source button is how you make sure you're connecting to an HDMI, because there could be multiple sources. Most of the time though, the monitor will figure out which thing you have plugged in. For this monitor, it's behind actually. There's a button here that I can press to go through the sources if I need to. So you may have that on the back of your monitor that you can work with your finger. But let's go back here, and as you can see, I have basically a duplicate monitor here, but we can change that. The settings for the Windows key and P brings up project settings. And we can, instead of duplicate, we can extend these. And now this laptop is powering two different monitors. I have this one here and I have, well, wait a minute, where is it? It's over here. So we can actually fix that. Let's go ahead and do that. We'll do that with the display settings. Right click and go down to display settings. And there you'll see we have two monitors listed. We can actually identify which one's which by clicking this button here. Screen one, screen two. And we can move these where they are. Some people may put the laptop on the other side. We can certainly do that. I've actually kind of stacked these for this video. So let's bring this down here to the bottom and a little bit to the left. Okay, and then hit apply. And now as I mouse over, it's a little more natural to go up and down between the two devices. So you can always rearrange your displays. The other thing about this display is you have two monitors now. So anything you do down here is only for one monitor at a time. So currently, I'm on number one. If I want to change number two, I'll click on it here so it's blue. And then go down and then I can scroll things around. In fact, let's do something here. Let's bring up Word and I'm gonna move this over to the monitor here. Okay. And then I'm gonna change the display for monitor two here. So let's make this really big. There it goes. Finally, if you're investing in your home office, your home setup, you might want to look at a docking station or a hub for your laptop. It has to be built especially for your model, make and model of your laptop, or there's universal ones out there. This is the Surface Dock that I can use with my Surface Book. And what it is, it allows you to plug in everything once. So if I have external keyboards or power cords, external drives, I can put in display ports here. I can even plug directly into the internet. Then this stays at the house, and I just have one cord that I plug in to my Surface device, and then so I can take the laptop with me, and then I plug in the cord if I want to work on the monitor, and the monitor fires up. I have power, internet, Bluetooth connections, all right there with the Surface Dock. Do you have any tips about how you work from home? We'd love to know in the comments below. And if there's anyone that you know that would benefit from this video, we hope you share and pass it along. Until next time for Simply Windows, I'm Doug. Bye-bye.